So the president said that he's having second thoughts about escalating the trade war. Why?
Well, look, if I can reinterpret that, I mean, he spoke to us. He didn't exactly hear the question. Actually, what he was intending to say is he always has second thoughts, and he actually had second thoughts about possibly a higher tariff response to China. So it was not to remove the tariff. He was thinking about a higher tariff response. Having said that, we're staying with the policy that was announced on Friday, as I believe, a 5% increase on the two tariffs, the first 250 and the second 300, September 1st and December 15th. And let me just say, on
so
this
he's
point,
thought, I just want to be clear on this. China, so he has thought that he might want to increase the tariffs, but he isn't actually going to increase the tariffs beyond what he initially did.
That is correct. At the moment, that is absolutely correct. That was his thought. It somehow got misinterpreted. I'm not sure he heard the question altogether. It was a very crowded room. I was there. But yeah, his thought was perhaps he needed to go higher. And my thought to you, Brianna, is simply, look, China took an action. It was a moderate action, a proportionate action. The president took an action related to China. As again, I said 5% plus from the original 250 and the next 300 or so, with the same due date, September 1st, December 15th, the same exemptions and waivers for a bunch of companies, consumer-related companies.
I do.
In my judgment, these are measured. Hang on a second, if you will. I want to just complete this thought. These were measured, proportionate thoughts. One point I want to make. Second point, Brianna, if I may. The conversation, the discussion between the China side and the U.S. side continues. Negotiations continue. There was a successful constructive deputies negotiation by teleconference last week. I believe another one is being scheduled for this coming week. And I also want to say that at least the U.S. side is continuing to plan for a visit from the China side sometime in the month of September. So the negotiating talks continue. That's an important point, I think.
But just to be clear on where his mind is on all of this, you're saying that this is because he would have considered an increased tariff, that actually he would have wanted to have more, but he is not, as you said, going to actually increase those tariffs. He also has said he's no longer planning on forcing U.S. businesses to leave China. So it does seem as if he is softening on this issue broadly.
Well, you disagree
with that.
Hang on if you... Well, a little bit. Look, again, this is about what he was thinking this morning. I think the early reporting was confused, but I'll leave that aside. Regarding the larger point, okay, so what he said last week on the tweet is he can't order business. He's not ordering business. There's no emergency powers being invoked.
Well, he
right
said
now.
He has the authority
he merely
to do that.
Said, he may, as I said, there's nothing right now in the cards. Ultimately, we do have such authority, but it is not going to be exercised presently. What he is suggesting to American businesses, and it's something he has said to many companies in many different forums and many different occasions, you ought to think about, to the companies, you ought to think about moving your operations and your supply chains away from China. And secondly, we'd like you to come back home. Come back to the USA, where we have very low corporate tax rates and a massive deregulation program, and our economy is doing just fine right now. And so come home, come back to America.
He said he ordered. Larry, just to be clear, he didn't say you oughta, he said he ordered. But I do want to talk about how this is being received there.
Well, he didn't order. He did not order the businesses. I know he said, I hereby order. But what he said to them, in effect, was that you begin to look or you begin to search for ways to move out of
China. I'm just thinking about what he actually tweeted, to be clear, the words that he tweeted. But I want to ask you about what's going on where you are, because the president's been getting a lot of pushback on his trade war. The EU leader, Donald Tusk, warned that this would, quote, lead to a recession. Macron says it is, quote, bad for everyone. And even his closest ally at the G7, the new UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson, said this.
Just to register the faint sheep-like note of our view on the trade war, we're in favor of trade peace on the whole. And that's what we want to see. So we're keen to see. We don't like tariffs on the whole.
We don't like tariffs on the whole, Johnson said. How are you responding to criticism from world leaders about the U.S. strategy with China?
Well, look, yeah, I'm not sure I agree how you portrayed that, to be honest. I was in that meeting.
What do you mean?
It
was that's a quote.
Yeah, well, that may be a quote, but sometimes you're taking a quote out of context. And let me try to generate some context. Again, I was in that meeting for 2 hours with the world leaders. Indeed, I participated in the meeting. First of all those world leaders, every single one of the seven leaders, the G7 plus
what's out
the
of,
new
Larry,
EU
Larry,
guy,
what's out of context? Because we've just rolled video. I mean, what is out of
agreed,
context with that quote?
If I might just finish my thought, please. I was there. I heard that every single one of those leaders agreed that China has exercised continuous debilitating and destabilizing unfair trading practices. Every single one of those leaders said that. And they expressed support for President Trump, who is leading the way to try to get China to make changes. Okay? Structural changes, IP theft, forced transfer of technology, high tariffs, etc. Every single one of them. I was in that room. And so that's why I'm saying what you may have said, and I don't know where these guys said that, is out of context. Now, let me also
I just have to take issue with that, Larry, because he said they may, look, there are a lot of people who think that China needs to be dealt with, but they do not like how the president is doing it. And that was Boris Johnson saying, we don't like tariffs on the whole. And he said, we're in favor of trade peace on the whole. He wanted to register a note of our view on the trade war. At Tusk, that this would lead to a recession. Macron, this is bad for everyone. This is what they've said, even if they have expressed some solidarity or empathy with what the president
yes,
is facing.
That's...
But
that's,
you cannot deny that they do not like how this is being operated.
Well, I will just say it all depends on the context. Now, we had breakfast with Prime Minister Johnson for about an hour and a half. He said he's a free trader. I'm a free trader. President Trump regards himself as a free trader. But the issue is how to deal with China's unfair trading practices, which have done great damage to the United States and the year and Europe and Japan. And there was widespread support for the president taking on China. Now, I can't attribute or I can't account for everything these folks say. And I'm not sure what you just played is something from that meeting. It sounds to me like it came after the meeting, which is why I wanted to raise the right context.
They're wholly behind President Trump.
Now, well, I was in that meeting and I can tell you the atmosphere in that meeting was constructive and
Larry, those words came
of
out of Boris Johnson's mouth.
And let me,
how
I know,
do you
and
argue
you'll, and
with
you'll
that?
Keep repeating that. So let me weigh in. Okay. Yes, I know. But Boris Johnson expressed support.
These
for
aren't mutually
President
exclusive
Trump's
ideas,
campaign
though.
To go after. Well, that's what I'm trying to say to you, that you're making a situation, you're taking it out of context. The total context here
I'm not taking
was
it out of
support for the president's policies. Let me go one more for you on this. The president has asked for the kinds of deregulatory and tax-cutting policies that have made the American economy a success. We're growing twice as fast as our allies. Every person around that table agreed they need to take additional measures to simplify and reduce regulations and taxes and grow more and focus more on prosperity. And that includes reducing trade barriers, and that includes reducing China's trade barriers. So I'm just trying to create the context. Actually, you want to know the truth, Brianna. I know you'll probably not agree. My view was the meeting this morning, in fact, the whole conference, including the unexpected luncheon between President Trump and President Macron, has gone very well, better than we thought, with a very positive vibe. So I will go that far and say, actually, it's been a solid gathering.
All right. Well, I just want to be clear. That was video of Boris Johnson speaking in that very meeting.